say it was tenacity. Our kids didn't work any harder to fill in the season than they did at the early part, but I told them to keep working. My certainly summer wars would come along the line, and so we felt real fortunate in winning those last two ball games.
Well, you must be both happy and a little bit saddened with a 5-5 season.
Well, I don't know. I'm sort of in between here. At the University of Virginia, we've been attempting to get on this winning track, and I'm not satisfied, naturally, with a 5-5 season. But we are pleased that at least the last 2 years that we've become, I would say, competitive in the Atlantic Coast Conference. The university had not, well, it always had been at the bottom of the heap. And the last 2 years now, we've finished in the first division. And we know that's no great stake, receiving for a championship, but at least we're improving.
You have lost some, or you will lose some players through graduation, some outstanding players, but yet you have a good nucleus coming back for next year.
Well, we feel we'll have a good nucleus. We lose some fine football players, and time is of essence here. I can't go into all those, but we'll have some good ball players back.
And, of course, John Naponic, you were telling me just a few minutes ago that he will be playing some basketball at Virginia this year.
That's right. John, as I mentioned, came in to me, came in to see me yesterday, and he's been thinking very seriously to play football, and he's playing in the North South team at Miami, Florida on Christmas Day. And he wondered whether he should play basketball. There was a little mix-up here. And I said, John, go play basketball because all the agility that you can get there, and you can certainly help the University of Virginia basketball team, they do it. And he said, okay, sir.